gentlemen, entrant number one from Paris Island, South Carolina, Lacey Evans.
Oh, yes, I remember now. Lacey,
she's like a sailor.
One.
Look at her.
Number one, I remember that.
I mean, she's not number one. Like,
I mean,
we're
no,
number one,
not number still, one. Like, she picked number one, yeah, so, you know.
Loses usually.
That's the worst
that.
Spot to have.
I miss Lacey. Such a sassy, sassy woman.
That's a one advantage of having number one. You can do an entrance.
A full-on entrance.
You don't have to worry about running. Sprinting.
Did I remember in NXT we took a photo together when we were in the auditorium? Because we both had buns. It was when I had my long hair. And we looked like sisters. Like, we looked exactly the same.
I just love Natty.
Gosh, being one of the first two entrants in the Royal Rumble, it's a big deal because it really shows that, you know, you have to be able to carry the match. You have to be able to really help out and navigate and set the tone for the match for the night. So being number two in that Women's Royal Rumble in 2019, it was really special because I knew, okay, I've got to really have my, like, game shoes on. I've got to really be ready because I don't know who's going to come out. I don't know what each girl's capabilities are. I don't know if there's going to be legends coming back from the past, and some of them haven't been in the ring in years. Like, I know it's a lot of weight on me, but it was also something I was up for the challenge for.
I would never want to be one or two.
No.
You have to outlast everyone else in the match.
No, and I don't even want to be next to these girls anyway. Yeah. So I'd have to be there the whole time.
Being the first two competitors is one of the hardest things that you could do.
And they're already wearing out their energy.
These women look good. Natty and Lacey Evans.
She's athletic, that Lacey.
But she's not the champion.
She's never had one of these.
The anticipation right before your music hits during a Royal Rumble match, it's just so exciting. And the crowd, you can't wait to hear them erupt when that 10-second countdown hits. And here it is.
Oh, the look who we have here.
It's gonna look good.
I will say her stretch, she decided not to run to the ring. She just did a swift walk.
It is kind of weird seeing me back with the blonde hair. I mean, this is the OG Mandy Rose, Golden Goddess. Okay, looking good. I mean, now, of course, look at me though. I got my title.
Love a good knee.
Back to my roots, literally. No pun intended.
She's strong to pick up an Addy.
I'm with Lacey. She's just chilling in the corner. I think that's a good strategy to stay there.
It was pretty exciting to be on, you know, to be in the match early on, being number three. Because, you know, depending on how long you're in there for, you better make sure your wind is good, because could be in there for a very long time.
As number 30, I'm not worried about anyone that's already in the ring, because I'm assuming they're just going to A, exhaust themselves, and B, be eliminated by the time I get out there. So I don't have to worry about them.
Ooh, I remember that. Natty gave us,
classic Natty, double sharpshooter.
The sharpshooter, oh no, not both of us.
The whole point of me putting on a double sharpshooter in the Women's Royal Rumble is to basically incapacitate my opponent so that it's easier to put pressure on their legs, their back, their neck, their arms, and then toss them over the top. So that was the goal of putting them into the double sharpshooter.
This did not feel good.
It does suck.
It's not fun.
It does suck.
Doesn't matter if you tap out in a Royal Rumble, that's for sure.
Liv! Livy Morgan.
Here she comes. Hopping down the ramp.
The Harley Quinn skip.
She decided not to run either. Just a little skip to the ring.
She's so cute.
Oh, the blue tongue. I remember that.
The blue tongue, the pink hair. This is old Liv.
Oh, gosh. That was a early elimination.
Oh my god, and she's already out. Oh, that's embarrassing. In and out.
Liv Morgan was tossed the fastest of any woman in the Royal Rumble, which was really cool because that wasn't something that she was expecting, but I was definitely happy to be the one to eliminate her.
Liv Morgan was the first one. Well, you know what? I was the first one the year before, so I think I was just so happy that I wasn't the first one in the next Royal Rumble match.
First elimination out of the way, so now we just gotta keep it going, keep it moving. The more people that's in there, the worse it is.
I mean, Liv had to get eliminated because she wasn't blonde. So there's only blondes in the ring, and she has pink hair, so.
Oh, here comes Mickie James.
I'm liking to see everyone's strategy. Are they just bolting to the ring? Are they taking their time? No one has booked it to the ring yet.
Ooh, when Mickie James came out, that was, it was so cool. I mean, Mickie is just so, she's so talented. She's a multiple-time women's champion. She's respected abroad. She's really, really talented, and she's done so much for women's wrestling. I mean, really, she's just incredible.
And it's nice for her because now she had a little bit of an advantage because Liv's already gone. So she only has to worry about the three of them. And she's, what, number five? But she's not blonde. Will she last? I don't know.
Yeah, she always brings the fire in the fight.
Okay, ooh. Natty.
Oh. I've never been on the tail end of that.
The forearm or the...
No, the kick.
The kick? It's not fun.
I almost eliminated her, so I thought it was pretty cool. Almost. You know, we never know who we're going to get in these matches as far as the legends that obviously paved the women's division to where it's at now. And I think it's always so exciting.
Growing up, I always wanted to be a part of the Royal Rumble. I just wanted to be a part of WWE in general. I never thought that any of those would ever happen. And they both have. I'm sitting here watching the 2019 Royal Rumble that was my first ever Royal Rumble I was a part of. And it was incredible.
The Royal Rumble is like the start of this WrestleMania season. And I feel like it's always like one of those things where you just never know what the outcome's gonna be. But then once the match is over, it's kind of like, okay, we know kind of what we're getting. And the start of, you know, who's competing, who's gonna main event WrestleMania. So it's very exciting.
Nikki A.S.H. I am not concerned about her at all because she's a slimy little snake and she's shown everyone her true colors, including myself. I don't open myself up to many people, and I finally did to Nikki after weeks of her begging me to. So now she's just made me mad.
I can't watch people wrestle and not move my body. I'm like, ooh, yeah.
Yeah, the Royal Rumble, it brings a lot of people together and it gets your imagination going. And you start picturing all these matches that could happen and you start getting real excited. And believe me, it's not only exciting for the fans, but it's exciting for us as well, because this sometimes makes like dream matches of ours. Like, I'm really hoping that this year, good old Beth Phoenix is in there again, because I've always wanted to step in the ring with Beth. And even if it's just a shot at the Royal Rumble, like, I'll take that shot. If I never get to have my one-on-one, I want the Royal Rumble at least.
So, gosh, Tamina is just a powerhouse. She really is. I mean, watching her in this Royal Rumble, it really reminds me of why I wanted to have Tamina Snuka as my tag team partner and why she was so worthy of being a women's tag team champion. So she's a force to be reckoned with. She's not to be messed with. And Tamina really is a diamond in the rough. You can see that in this match.
There's a lot of people.
Honestly, staying in the Royal Rumble for a long time is, of course, a lot of fun, and the goal is to win the Royal Rumble, but you need to make sure your cardio is so on point and your stamina is, like, top-notch, because it takes a lot of energy, breathing, and there's just so many things, and at this point, you know, halfway through the Rumble, you're gassed, like... You are gassed, so you and there's so many things going through your mind. It takes a lot. I give like all these women so much credit because especially Natalia and Lacey, who are still in.
Hey Charlotte, are you missing this? Oh, that's right, you never got one.
Yeah, watching Charlotte get into the ring, I mean, she comes in like a wrecking ball. She's taken everybody down. She's coming in there dominant. The one thing about Charlotte is that she brings a lot of intensity in her performances. So it was really nice having her in there.
Yeah, everyone saw what happened in the 2020 Royal Rumble and how it could change the landscape of everything and change someone's career. For me, I was sitting there doing the watch along, and I remember Charlotte winning, and everyone turned to me. I'm sitting there with my NXT Women's Championship, and they're like, "What would you do if Charlotte decided to challenge you?" And me just being me, I was like, "She can bring it. I mean, I'm down for it. Golden ticket to WrestleMania. I'll take my shot." Didn't think that it was going to happen, and then it did. So it really did help skyrocket my career. It made a lot more people know who the hell Rhea Ripley is, because I did have that main stage opportunity. So it could definitely make people's careers, and that's another reason why I love the Royal Rumble.
Okay. Who's next? The countdown is on. I think I know who's next. I think I remember. Oh, feel the glow.
Naomi, I was a tag partner with her at one point.
My arch nemesis.
Feel the glow. Look, she's booking it to the ring.
You always know Naomi has some tricks up her sleeve.
I always look forward to what she's gonna do.
She's so cool. Those colors.
Oh man, with Naomi, it's incredible. Like, she is truly the epitome of an innovator in the industry.
Oh, this is when she tries to eliminate me, I remember. Oh, and she gave me a really great wedgie this time too, I remember that.
Oh, this was, were they fighting she was going after Naomi's husband at that point?
I think so.
I think they were doing a little something there.
She eliminated me. Ew. Naomi.
No, hold on. No.
Well, that's rude. Mandy got out of the match and she's trying to get Naomi. Oh.
Oh.
Naomi's about to do something cool.
Okay, Naomi. Never in my wildest dreams could I be that athletic.
She's really athletic, Naomi. I have to give it to her.
Maybe. She's not even real, but the things that Naomi does.
Oh, God. The balance you have to have to walk on the barricade.
Oh my God. Mm-mm. It's giving me anxiety. Please don't fall.
She's walking that far. I definitely would have fallen. I'm way too clumsy.
It's very innovative. I'll give her that.
Oh, that's God. A far... Look at that.
Oh, my God.
Mm-mm.
No
Mm-mm.
way.
Ah! Oh, my God. That was quite the jump, too.
She's so cool.
Look at the crap.
No!
Oh! After all that. Not today, honey. Actually, I do remember the crowd erupting for that. Not gonna lie. That was a great reaction. And I was just soaking it all in.
What a sore loser.
Wow.
Look at you, all proud of yourself.
Rude.
All eliminated and proud. I mean, I probably would have done the same thing.
I know, me too. Who are we kidding?
Me and Candace had some really interesting times in NXT.
Tell us about it.
I try not to hold grudges, but it's...
So you don't get along with her?
You know, maybe now I probably would, but back then I just wanted to rip her extensions out.
She's almost a mom now.
Right, you can't do that.
Yeah, you gotta be nice to her now. What do you think about doing a submission in a Rumble match? You use it to wear them down?
But you're also going to get run down too.
Right.
It's like,
too much energy.
Way too much.
Oh. Oh, Natty and Charlotte in the corner. Natty is such a baddie.
You know, it's just... She also...
This little athlete right
she's
here.
A ninja.
She is the ninja.
She's not like... Naruto ninja, but she's like a ninja.
She's pretty pretty athletic.
No, she's... I remember she did something actually in here.
Yeah, I think she like... Oh.
Ninja
okay.
Art.
I mean, this is insane. Never in my wildest dreams.
Actually, I think you could.
I mean, definitely. I could probably do it better.
I think you definitely can do it better. You can
so
actually
tiny.
Crab dance better than them too.
Oh my God,
I've
of
seen
course.
You dance.
I actually won the first place in the crab walk when I was in second grade, so.
I 100% believe it.
Oh my gosh, oh. Wow.
God, you remember that time I did that better?
Yes.
So crazy.
Every time you do it.
Every time. I still say that we take it to the, what is that?
She's basically, oh.
Come on, off to the loony bin. Off to the loony bin, let's go.
Get her, someone get her, just kick her off.
Come on, Casey. You're little, but you're not stupid. Let's go.
You know what? She's just inexperienced.
Oh, is this?
Is this you?
Is this me? It is me. Look at how amazing I look. Okay, this is Vega.
Tell me about this.
From Street Fighter. Look, and okay. You know who knew that? Your guy knew that.
He did know
he
that.
He did say that on the thing.
He's so smart.
I know. But you know what? So this is Vega from Street Fighter. My last name, it was perfect. I had the colors, the snake, the mask, the claw. I made it myself, actually.
You did? Mm. Wow, that's talent.
I know. But I'm a queen now. I don't have to do that.
Right. You have peasants do that for you.
This is why I'm so much bitter. Oh boy, this
oh,
moment.
Oh, here we go. Here we go.
This moment. See, Hannah don't like each other. But you know, it's funny. If this was in front of an NXT crowd, they would have really understood it.
Sure.
But they didn't get it because they didn't know her. Because who does?
Well, yeah. What's her name?
Kandai Lubin.
You guys are going at it. You are mad.
I'm angry. Oh. I'm super mad. Ooh.
I do love your gear.
Thank you. It's really good. It's so, you know.
Reminds me of the Lakers.
Oh, okay. Thank you.
Royal Rumbles are just, like, so much fun because there's so many women that you haven't seen in a while or that you never worked with. You know, the past, the present, the future. It's just such a blast.
I just saw you roll under the rope, so you're not eliminated.
Selena just crawled straight under the bottom rope.
Oh.
I See? Remember this, yeah.
That's so smart.
Nobody saw me.
That's so like, smart.
Like the little rat bag that she is, trying to get out of the danger zone. She's hiding under the ring. That strategy is... I don't want to say it because it's going to be bad what I'm going to say, so let's just put it this way. It's the weak way out. It's definitely the... It's smart, but it's also the weak way. So... My Australian lingo won't let me say it any other way.
Kick him in the face, EO!
Io Shirai is so good. She's so good. She looks so different. Like with her little curled hair, the little red gear, the shorts. The nerves were unreal. I remember standing in line in Gorilla and I was like, oh crap, I'm next. I didn't think that I was ready. I was absolutely terrified. I was like, there's a lot of people out there. But it's so different when you walk through the curtain. Like, I was so nervous, but as soon as I walked up the steps and I went out there in front of the crowd, I was like, I got this. I'm good.
Oh my gosh, look who it is!
It's Rhea Ripley.
Rhea Ripley.
Yo, look at the hair though. The hair evolution, you gotta respect it. That stomp, quick exit from the jacket, running like the true beefcake that I am.
I mean, I don't know if she's nice really, because I'm pretty sure I got tossed out by her, so.
Uh-oh.
The John Cena slide in, already beating people up. I was so worried that the crowd wouldn't know who I was. I was so worried. I turned around and I saw people like screaming for me and I got so excited.
Dana Brooke, my other old tag team partner.
Oh, little Casey Catanzaro. You leave her alone, Dana. Oh, this is where she does the handstand, isn't it? She does something fancy. She's another one that's just incredibly talented. Oh yeah, it's the handstand. There she goes, walking on her hands.
Oh, you're kidding.
Oh my God.
Look at this.
If she's still in it.
That was awesome.
How the hell do people do that? I know what's gonna happen. Yoink. Out of the air. Do a couple spins. Spinny, spinny, spin. Try a DDT me. Doesn't work, mate. Doesn't work when you weigh 95 pounds. And goodbye. Even the spider monkey herself can't get out of that. Oh, Sonya.
There's my girl, Sonya Deville. Oh my God, I totally forgot. She is sprinting down the ramp.
Damn, she running. She running.
Like a maniac.
Straight in a beating crap out of me. Thanks, Sonya.
Oh my God. I remember seeing that after I got eliminated, but like, whoa. Honey, don't trip. Oh my God, she's so funny.
I want to wrestle Sonya. I think it'd be a lot of fun.
Wow, it's amazing to see, like, so many change their looks, and I mean, speaking of changing their look, but just like evolve, and it's only been a couple years. It's crazy. Oh gosh, Dana, that fall. Damn.
Oh, there you are!
Oh my gosh, this is when Zelina was under the ring.
Oh my God!
That little, oh God.
Oh, there's Hornswoggle. This is a little green gremlin.
I didn't know he was there. I had no idea. He was there. He just...
That's amazing.
I thought maybe higher ground would help me, and it didn't.
That is amazing.
This was actually really entertaining. This was amazing. So funny.
He's just...
Oh, my God.
He's very aggressive in his love. He's just... He's very passionate.
Gotcha, Zelina. Man, hasn't really changed much, has it?
I don't even know what that was.
Oh, my gosh.
My life... Flash before my eyes, I kid you not.
Well, I blame Hornswoggle.
I look like a starfish running out of there. I
wanted to kick him so bad.
He's trying to get your number? Like, what was happening here?
I don't know. He just kept saying, hi. Hi. And I was just like, hi, leave me alone. Like, what are you chasing me for?
Pure confusion on my face.
That's amazing. But it's because of him you got eliminated. If right. It wasn't for him, maybe you would have won the Rumble.
That's probably a thing.
Bailey, that's the old Bailey.
This is good Bailey.
Yes,
happy Bailey.
Nice Bailey. Wayable, side pony Bailey.
Flaby and Tubman.
Bailey just chucked my ass out the ring.
Bye, Rhea.
Oh,
see ya, Rhea.
How your knees?
I hurt my bum so bad.
Oh yeah, this is when she got injured earlier in the night.
She's making her way.
Honey, you better hurry up.
I mean, so look, you look at Lana, poor Lana just hobbling down there, just trying her best to get to the ring. But she was, I can't remember what had happened to her. I know she had gotten an injury just before that, and she was out in crutches. And so, if there was ever going to be an opportunity, Lana was going to be my opportunity.
Yeah, I remember watching Lana do her entrance, and I was like, I don't know if she's going to be able to compete in this match.
God bless her, she was really having a tough time.
She looked like she was in way too much pain. So then my wheels started turning in my head, and I was like, what could happen? What's gonna happen? And I was trying to figure it out, and I didn't even think of the possibility that did happen.
I'm watching everything unfold. I'm watching the people come out. Who's going next? What's gonna happen? I knew that there was 30 women in the Rumble, so there wasn't a place for me. But should something like this happen, should somebody not ever make it into the ring, then, well, that would be a huge opportunity for me then, wouldn't it?
Here comes Nia. Uh-oh.
Lana still hasn't made it. She had to stop on the sideline. She had a little bit of a water break, and doctors were tending to her. She was still trying. God bless her, she was still trying. That's what I love about Lana, you know? It doesn't matter what happens. She's always going to try, and she's going to try as hard as she possibly can.
Poor Lana. I feel like all Nia did, Lana's whole career, was just torture her.
And then here comes Nia Jax, who decided that she didn't want Lana to get in the match. Biggest mistake she ever made, am I right?
So I'm pretty sure I'm next. I think 30 is next. And I was so worried because I think everyone was down except Nia. So like, what do I do?
Oh my God. Poor Io.
Yeah, so Nia just got into the ring, and this is actually towards the very end of the match. I was in there for quite a while, and I was, you know, I mean, this is the match where I was the Iron Woman. I was in there for over 55 minutes. So when Nia got her hands on me, I was just like, I was hanging by a thread.
Oh my God, Natty, okay.
Natty, look at you with the strength.
Nia's a big, tall girl. I lifted her up, put her on my shoulders, and almost tipped her out.
There goes Natty. Natty, you had a good run. That was a long time. Props to you.
For me to last that long, over 55 minutes, it really is why I call myself the Iron Woman of the WWE. To me, it's just a testament of my heart and how much I put into my work and my drive and determination and my relentlessness in the ring. And, you know, I may not have won it, but I always bring everything I have to the table and do everything I can to show why I am the best of all time.
Okay. Oh my God, look at your hair.
Oh my gosh, I really love the dark hair.
Carmella. Mella is money. Here she comes.
Look at how I'm running. I'm like doing a Baywatch run. Okay, Pamela. Get her.
Look at you.
Oh my God, yes. Down goes Nia Jax.
So I thought they were blue. They're not new colors. They're purple. It's really
I was
cute.
Wearing Phoenix Suns colors because I thought, I think we were in Phoenix that year.
And that was the thing. We knew in advance that Carmella was going to be entrant number 30. She had won an opportunity to become entrant number 30. So we knew that that was going to happen. So there was no chance that I was going to take Carmella's spot, well, unless I took her out in the back. I mean, big time Bex would probably take her out in the back, but the man wouldn't. The man was a bit more honorable than that.
I don't really know who makes the rules, because I thought it was 30.
She just looked like she would argue with him for another hour. So
she's like, what part of Ireland are you from? And he's like, I'm from this part. What about you?
The fit is the authority here. That is great news for me. Because if Fit has the chance to make a decision where I'm involved, I think he might pull in the Irish favor, you know? Us Irish, we look out for each other.
Fit was just like, you're never gonna shut up.
Yeah, he's like, just go.
Just go.
Whatever.
I think I just yelled at him for long enough. I got in his face and annoyed him for long enough. I think that's sometimes that's the best way to get things done around here. Sorry, Lana. Sorry, I didn't really care about Lana then. I just wanted to get in the match. I wanted to go on. I wanted to pick Ronda, face Ronda at WrestleMania, become the first woman to win the main event of WrestleMania, and the people wanted it too. The people wanted it.
You've been in here for quite a while. Oh, she's coming for you.
Ah, no!
She's coming for you.
Not today. Eat my boot.
And my baby boot set follow.
Here we go. Of course, you gotta get that moonwalking, girl.
This is impressive.
Mella is money, honey. Oh, and I think Bailey and I worked together to get Alexa out. It's the only elimination I've ever had in a Rumble.
I don't think I actually ever had
one. And it was
one.
Assisted. Now I'm back on Charlotte. Her hair got messed up again. Oh, here we go. Yes!
There you go, got one.
So proud of me. We're friends, me and Bailey.
I've heard this is a thing. Oh, look at you.
Okay.
Oh, no.
No, please don't. Don't do it.
Don't do it.
Come on, Carmella. Last. Oh, no.
Okay, the final two, Becky and Charlotte, and former best friends turned into true enemies.
I thought I could do it. She had one chance left. She kicked out my knee.
It's always a fight when they get in the ring together. This was like a very entertaining last two.
She's looking at me with hate in her eyes, wants to take me out. Thinks this is her opportunity.
They know each other so well. Charlotte looks so mad.
These two brought the fight. I do remember that for sure.
I'm trying to pull myself up on my bad leg.
Charlotte's charging.
And over she goes. Down you go. Boom. Out you go. Out you go. And I'm the winner. Here is
your winner. So Becky comes in, enters herself into the Royal Rumble match at 31, and wins it.
Hell yeah, Bex.
And I'm going to the main event of WrestleMania.
She weaseled her way in
there. She sure did. So you gotta give her a little credit, right?
A little credit. I mean, that's what we would do.
Of course. Can't falter.
No.
I remember watching this out the back, and everyone was just cheering and screaming. It was so cool. Such a good moment. She's been fighting her whole career for moments like this, and it's so sweet to see.
I was supposed to take my loss to Asuka and sit in the back and think about what could have been. But then I saw an opportunity and I took it. And I think that's the thing about life. There's little opportunities always lurking, and sometimes you just have to be aware of them and ready to pounce.
We all want to point at the WrestleMania sign. It's something that we've all seen over the years, and everyone dreams of it. I don't care what you say, everyone dreams of it.
You know, you just gotta get the point in. It's where you're headed to next. It's what your future looks like. And it's just an amazing accomplishment that most, you know, superstars want to have. They want to have that experience in their career. So hopefully one day I get that.
There was not a single doubt in my mind that I wasn't going to win that Royal Rumble. I had lost in the beginning of the night. I wasn't taking two L's in one night. Hell no. Hell no. This was fate. This was what meant to happen. I took advantage of my opportunity, and you can take advantage of yours by watching the Royal Rumble on January 29th exclusively on Peacock in the USA and the WWE Network everywhere else.